I remember when he first told me about this girl named Nebby. Everything he told me about her, she sounded wonderful, and I could see it in his eyes from that moment that this was the girl that he loved. This was gonna last a long time. After seeing everything they went through, like I said, persistence really played a huge part in this, but I finally meet her and I get to hang out with her and I realize that everything he had said about her was true. She's an absolutely wonderful person. She's beautiful, she's intelligent, she just makes everyone so happy when she's around. When I think about my best friend and I think about who I want him to be with, I think of him. I remember the moment that he called and asked if it was okay. Did he think it was too soon to get married? And I said, absolutely not, because you're gonna spend forever together and you might as well start now. We've talked about in scripture where it says that two become one flesh. I've always associated that with marriage, but now I have associated with my friendship as well, because not only do I have a best friend in Kobe, but I have a best friend in Megan. I saw your face, you're gonna make me cry. I have someone I can rely on when I'm hurting. I have someone who can pray with me. I have someone who I can put my trust into, laugh, cry, and share every emotion with. I am so thankful that you've brought her into my life, and I'm so thankful and blessed to be a part of what y'all are gonna have in y'all's life.
So as I got even older, I still blamed her, but in different ways. I blamed her for being my personal Jiminy Cricket when I was about to make a bad life choice. I blamed her for many of the tears that I shed when I left for college, for making me realize for the first time that I cared about and loved someone so much more than myself. I blame her for making me a better person because I needed to be the sister that she deserved. How am I supposed to fit a lifetime of jokes, friendship, and love into a few minutes? It's very surreal just to look at you, Megan, today, and see this rock star of a woman before me, when if I just close my eyes, I can picture the little girl that I played countless hours of Barbies with, and the little girl that I did the Hungry Hungry Hippo line with. Cody, you are the missing piece. Cody is very kind. He's just giving and just dorky enough to fit in. And most importantly, the way that he looks at Megan is the way that Cody looks at me. And I just know that you're always going to be there for her and love her and support her. May our marriage be filled with joy, love, and faith in the Lord. May you be fruitful and multiply. And may the Lord be with you.
My discotheque.